I don't remember much about my mum. All I can remember is blurry images of her, and sometimes I hear her voice. I remember the day she died. I was 5. I remember the pain and the anger that my dad had, and how it festered, grew, and then one day morphed into something more sinister. An addiction. His way out. Fast forward 12 years, my grandma on my dad's side moved in with us not long ago after her health took a turn. She's lazy and won't do anything for herself. You can't even get her to go for a walk if you paid her, which led to her having incredibly weak knees. And my dad, he's still the same man he always was. He just has a gaping hole that he fills up every day with special brew, which leaves no space for love. Not only is the alcohol eating his liver, it's eating his heart.
I'm not eating this.
What?
I'm not eating this.
You're in my ass, you eat my bloody food!
That's a dead animal.
It's food.
Why can't you just love animals? Look at that dog. You love him. Why can't you love others like you love him? They're just the same. We're all the same.
It's food, just bloody eat it.
And life has been taken away just for your convenience and satisfaction.
The food does look a bit shit, Dad.
It's my right to eat what I want.
Bye.
Where are you going? You haven't finished your food.
Party.
No, you're not. You're going to sit down and finish your bloody food.
Was it any good?
What?
The party. How was the party?
Yeah, it wasn't bad. What you call my phone if I barely pronounce I lose your feelings? Deep down with plenty of reasons, but you're too drunk to say I'm leaving. What's the point in dating if you find it hard? Working off the top, can't be no flop. When I get that cash drop, hey, life unlocked. I'll do this thing on my own. Just start on my own.
I remember when I was your age, we'd have these parties, and you feel as if you're invincible. You're just living life. And the people you're with think you'll know forever. And then suddenly, you're older. And all those times are just distant memories. I bet half of my friends back then were dead. But remember that all your friends and memories you have will now fade away. So never stop being yourself. Memories will become nothing but memories.
Yeah, you're right. Why is everyone so full of hate?
People always have been. Humans, they love conflict. Makes them feel good.
What the fuck are you doing here?
Think about it. It's in our nature. Peace will never exist as long as there are humans.
Is Dad up yet?
He's still asleep, I think.
Can you take your nan for a walk?
What?
Take her out for a walk. She needs the fresh air.
You know, I should have never ignored you. I blocked you out all through secondary school. Just didn't know who I was. Tried to be someone else. I was so weak-minded looking back.
Oh, love, that's not true. We all go through rough patches in life. I mean, we're living on a rock. Floating through a vast expanse. We're so irrelevant, nothing really ever matters. You do something wrong, who cares? What's the worst that can happen? You die. That's the worst that can happen. Ask out a girl you like. Ask that person for a job. Confront your bully. You're born, you die, and everything in between is just from A to B. How you go about that journey makes you, you. But you'll be fine. You're above it all.
Did you copy all of that from a book?
No, dear. It's my wisdom. It comes with age. You know what I love? Nature. I love the idea of being buried one day under a great oak tree. One that's sturdy and strong, with long, lanky branches that stretch over the fields. Because then I feel that when I die, it's as if I've become part of it. Part of the tree as it leans and sways, and my soul can breathe. And as leaves fall, I heal the earth and give back to nature what I've used.
Where'd you get all this from?
Nature. Makes me think, you know. You've really got to appreciate it.
Yeah, you're right. Never know when this will turn into a housing estate or something.
Oh, no, don't say that, love. It's a sad truth, though. We have to make the most of it.
Right, let's get back then. God, I wish you could walk. I'm going to end up needing to be pushed around soon.
How come she's talking to you? I can't get a word out of her.
You have to be patient with her. You just shout all the time. You can't exactly expect her to open up if you just treat her like a dog.
I'll treat her however I damn well please.
Of course. Can you take me to a party later?
I'm going down a pub. When do I ever get a chance to enjoy myself? I'm just always a bloody taxi service.
You drink all the time. All I want is a lift.
It doesn't always revolve around you. No one ever gives a bloody shit about me.
I only want to be dropped off. Just take me for once. Is it really that hard?
You and her walk all over me. I never get what I want.
Who are you? Do you get sad that you don't know how long you've got left?
No, I've had a good life for the most part. I'm not blind. I'm not deaf. Got full use of my body, apart from these. I've been very lucky. I've won the lottery of life. You know, the odds of being born are 1 in 400 trillion.
How the hell do you know that?
Books. I've read so many of them.
That's true. Why don't you use your legs?
There's no use trying with them, dear. They're long gone. Oh, but I do wish I could dance again.
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show. Three to get ready now. Go, cat, go. But don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but step over my blue suede shoe. Well, you can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Well, do anything that you want to do, but not, honey, lay off them shoes. And don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do.
Those days are gone now. Wow. Looking back, time really flies. One minute you have all the time in the world. And enough dreams to fill it. And the next, You're ready to retire. And all those hopes and dreams just passed you by.
You still have time. Sure you don't want to keep this?
Oh no, get rid of it. That way I'll have no excuse, will I?
Why'd you get rid of that bloody wheelchair?
She doesn't need it.
Oh. Oh. Oh no.
Annie, you're right. Grandma. You were right. I'm gonna fly.
Oh, you a heron? Oh, you're an oak tree.
What? What do you mean?
Looks like one.
Grandma, listen to me. What's wrong with you? Why don't you understand?
Take your nana away, she's been a bloody nuisance.
He died on a Saturday morning. Brain tumor can be stopped. I had you cremated. I didn't get to say goodbye to you. Hardly saw you on your last days. You wouldn't take me. I don't know what else to say. You changed who I was. I realised that Grandma wasn't lazy. She was just tired of life. She'd lost her husband and that hit her like a ton of bricks. She lost her purpose, her motivation. But I like to think that I made the last few moments of her life just bearable. Bearable enough to keep going. I didn't save her. She saved me.